In this session, we are going to discuss about startup and shutdown of CDB and PDB. So starting up the CDB instance. So first of all, we need to start the CDB, then we can start the PDB. So first of all, you can just connect it to the CDB one instance as a switch DBA, and then you can just start your CDB database up to no mount mode. And after that, you can just check the status of all your PDBs, right? After starting up to no mount mode, you can just mounting the CDB. That again just connected to CDB 1 as a switch DBA, startup mount mode. Directly you can just start up to mount mode. Also, if your database in the no mount mode, you can just start up to, again you can just alter database CDB 1 to mount mode. And you can just check the also status of the PDB at this moment. Next, opening the CDB. Directly you can just opening the database startup command, or else if your database is in the mount mode, you can just issue the command alter database CDB 1 open. So it is going to be open. Also at this moment, just check the your status of the v$PDB. After opening the your CDB, next is opening the PDB. So you can just connect as a sys user at the CDB 1 as a sys DBA, and after that what you can do, alter pluggable database PDB 1 open. So it is only going to open your PDB 1 database. Also you can open all your pluggable database issuing only one command, that is the alter pluggable database all open. Here you can just check the status of the PDBs, all the PDBs. Okay, closing the PDB. Once you open it, in case if you want to close the any of the PDB, you can just close PDB 1, close immediate. So it is going to close your immediate, your PDB 1 database. Fine, this is the same as a shutdown immediate. Alter pluggable database all except PDB 1 close. Fine, so here it is not going to close your PDB 1 database, except PDB 1 it is going to close all your database. After that, you can just close all your database. So here you have three options. Either you can just close only one database, also you can just close except one database, and also the last one, close all the pluggable database. After this, connected to PDB and then close. So here we directly connected to sysdb and we close it, but in case if you want to connect to the PDB and then if you want to close, you can also close alter pluggable database close. So you at this moment you are connected to PDB 1, fine. So you no need to give the pluggable database name, it is going to close your PDB 1 database. Also you can issue the command shutdown immediate if you are connected to the pluggable database. You can issue the shutdown immediate command, which is going to shut down your PDB 1 database. Shut down the CDB instances. So if you want to shut down the CDB instance, you can directly issue the command shutdown immediate. Next, trigger to automatically open the PDB after the startup. See, in some project requirement, if the CDB is open, your all PDB should be open automatically. This is the project requirement. Fine. So each and every time, whenever you start up the your container database, then each and every time you no need to start up all the pluggable database. So in case if you have a 10 pluggable database, so what you need to do, you need to, after opening the CDB, you need to open also the all 10 pluggable database. But what you can do, if our project requirement is that open CDB and also open all the PDB under that CDB, so you can create the one trigger. So that is the after startup on database trigger you can create. So here create trigger open all PDBs after startup on database. So once the database is startup, execute immediate alter pluggable database all open and open all PDB. So this trigger, when it's fired, after the startup on database. So once the after the startup of database is done, here it will execute this command alter pluggable database all open. So all the PDBs are going to be open. Fine. So you can just create after startup on database trigger to open all the PDBs automatically once the CDB is started. Changing the PDB mode. So if you want to change the pluggable database mode, so one is a restricted mode. So you just connect to the PDB 1 database. So then close the PDB 1 database and you can just open into the restricted mode. You can just open into the restricted mode, not in open read write mode. Also, you can just check at this moment your PDB status. In case if you want to open into read only mode, so what you can do, alter pluggable database, open all, read only. So this is going to be open on only read only mode. So let's see all these things practically.
So let's see startup and shutdown of CDB and PDB. So if you want to start the container database, how can you start? So first of all, just connect it to the SQL Plus. Fine. So you are connected to the ideal instance. Now, if you want to start, first of all, into no mount mode. So how can you start? Startup no mount. Fine. You can use this connection identifier also, and directly you can also connect to the your container database. So first of all, start the database into no mount mode. So initially we are starting into the no mount mode. Fine. And after that, you can just check the status. Select name open mode from v$pdb. Select what is the status of PDB. Sorry, this is the open mode. Fine, no row selected because you just keep the database CDB database into no mount mode. Now mounting the database. So directly you can mount, you can issue this command startup mount, but we already no mount it. So we can just do the alter database CDB one mount. So let's see. Fine, so here you can just CDB1 mount mode. In this way, you can just mount your container database. Here you can also check the status of PDB. So here you can see all the PDBs are in the also mounted mode. So PDB files are also mounted. Fine. Next, you can see opening the CDB. So if you want to open the container database, how can you open? Directly you can issue the startup command, or if you already mounted, you can just use alter database CDB one open. Fine. So you have opened the your container database. After that, what you can do, you can just check the status. So simply just check the status of all the PDBs, because you know already the your container database is open. So this is open by default into the read-only mode, because PDB seed is always in the read-only mode. And all these three PDBs, PDB1, PDB2, PDB3 and PDB4 are in the mounted mode. So it is not open. Fine. So you need to remember, whenever you are opening the your container database, PDB seed is always in the read-only mode and other PDBs are by default into the mounted mode. Fine. Now, after doing CDB, all these things, no mount, mount and open, next open the pluggable database. So you already connected to the root container. After that, just open all the PDB. So first of all, I'm just opening the one PDB, alter pluggable database PDB one open. If you want to open all your PDB, what you can do, alter pluggable database all open. This command you can execute. This is going to open all your PDB. If you want to only open one PDB, just issue this command. So now you can issue this command, alter pluggable database all open. So this is going to open your all PDB. Fine. It is going to open PDB 1, PDB 2, PDB 3 and PDB 4. So these things you need to remember. After that, we can just check the status. Select name open mode from v$pdb. So here just issue the command, just check the status. All are in the read write mode. Fine. So here you can just check PDB1 read only, that is always, and these three are in the read write mode. So in this way, you can also open the your pluggable database. Next is close the pluggable database. So if you want to close the pluggable database, what you can do? Alter pluggable database PDB 1, close immediate. So this is going to be close your pluggable database immediate. Fine, if you want to close accept PDB 1. So how can you do this thing? So here, what you can do? Alter pluggable database PDB 1, close immediate. This is going to close your pluggable database 1. Fine, so this is closing the PDB 1. After that, you can just check the status. Fine, so this is the mounted mode. Now, if you want to close all PDB except PDB 1, so you can issue this command. All except 1. So this is going to close all the PDB except PDB 1. Now, here, if you want to close all PDB, what you can do? Alter pluggable database all close. So this is going to close all your PDB. So pluggable database all closed. You can just check the status. Fine. This is the mounted. So all the PDBs are closed. Fine. So in this way, you can just open all your PDB and close all your PDB. Fine. Another method to close the PDB is that you can just connect it to that particular PDB and just issue the command alter pluggable database close. So first of all, let me open the PDB because we already closed all the PDB. So if you want to open, what is the method? Alter pluggable database PDB 1 open read write. Fine. Now let me open the pluggable database 3 also. So connect. Fine. Now close PDB 3. So here you don't have, if you have insufficient privileges to close the PDB, so what you can do? Fine, you are connecting as a sys user. Show con name, because we have not given any permissions to the pdb_admin. So here you can just close this pluggable database. Fine. So in this way, once you connect it to the PDB 3, after that, just issue the command alter pluggable database close. Fine. After that, you no need to write down PDB 3 close because you already connected to PDB 3. So in this way, you can also close the pluggable database. Now, if you want to shut down the CDB instance, how can you shut down? Directly just issue the command shut down immediate. So here, just issue the command show con name. This is the very important that you need to check PDB 3. Shut down immediate. Fine. So here you are shut down the all the PDBs as well as CDB. So in this way, you can just shut down. Next, database event trigger automatic PDB opening. See, at this moment, what happened? Whenever you are creating, whenever you are connecting to the CDB and whenever you are starting up the CDB database, on that time, PDBs are in the mounted mode. Fine. So what we need to do is, we need to, whenever we are starting up the CDB, on that time, pluggable database also going to be started. Fine. So for that, we need to create the after startup trigger. So what you can do is, here database trigger to automatically open PDB after the startup. So after startup on database, this trigger you need to create. So what you need to do? Create trigger, open all PDB trigger name after startup on database, begin, execute immediate, alter pluggable database, all open. So here and open all PDBs. Fine, so this is going to be executed once you, after startup, this is going to be executed and this is going to open all your pluggable database. So let's see this thing practically. So here I am just issuing the command startup and I am just creating the trigger after startup on database. So just creating this trigger of which is the main alter pluggable database, all open. Fine, so this is going to be open here. Trigger is created. Fine, create trigger, open all PDBs after startup on database, execute immediate, alter pluggable database, all open. So at this moment, you can just check the status of the PDBs. So select, you can just take it name open mode from v$PDBs. So simple, just check the status mounted. Now I have created all these, this created, I have a trigger. So let me first shut down the database and I'm starting the database again. So what is going to be happen? Initially it is in the mount mode, but now whenever I'm starting the database, that is going to be all the open into read write mode, because here I have created the trigger, that is the after startup trigger. After here you can see, yeah, after startup on database, this is going to execute the command. Let's see startup. This process will take some time because you are opening the CDB as well as all the PDBs. Fine. So this, all the PDBs are open. Now you can just check the status. So select name from comma open mode from v$PDB. So here you can see all are by default into read write mode after creation of the trigger. So this is the very important thing, that is your database event trigger automatically PDB opening. Fine, this trigger you can create and you can easily just open all your database whenever you are opening the container database. Fine, next is changing the PDB mode. So if you want to change the, your PDB mode, fine, how can you change? So first connect it to the PDB, then just close the PDB and just open into the restricted mode. Fine, so if you want to open not in the read write mode, but if you want to open into restricted mode, so you can just do in this way. So let's do practically. So first of all, connect sys. PDB 3. Now close this pluggable database. Close it. Open into the restricted mode. Fine. So you can just open into the restricted mode. Alter pluggable database, open restricted. Open restricted. So this is the database is altered. Fine, and after that you can just check the status of the your PDBs. This is the very important, just check the status. Fine, so here it is into read write mode. It is in the open, but it is in the read write mode. Fine, this is the, you have just restricted it. Fine, now open into the read only mode. So here what you can do, open all your database into the read only mode, not read write mode. So what you can do, issue the command alter pluggable database, all open read only. So in this way you can also keep your all the pluggable databases to the read only mode. You need to just issue the simple command alter pluggable database, all open read only. If you want to open it into read write, open all open read write. Fine, so this is the simple command. So in this session, we have discussed about startup and shutdown of CDB and PDB. Thank you.